gospel. Myself this morning, fill me from above. Holy Spirit, take control of my life this morning. Empower your word from above. Speak your word to me. Let my inner man receive fire this morning through your word. Let me receive healing. Let me receive favor. Let me receive abundant blessing through your word this morning. Liberate me, Lord. Plant me in a fertile land through your word this morning. Don't let me come into your presence in vain, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Everlasting Father, King of glory, we thank you, Lord, again this morning for the privilege given to us to be in your sanctuary. We give you all the glory, all the adoration. Be thou extend our mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Father, Lord, we are going to your word this morning at the entrance of your word as a liberty. Yes. That Lord, liberate us through your word this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Empower your word from above this morning, Lord. Both the speaker and the hearer, teach us from above this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. That Lord, I disappear and you appear this morning, Lord. Amen. And let your word this morning have impact in our life. Thank you for answering our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise our mighty Jesus. Amen. Let us be seated in his presence. We are welcome to this service today. And I pray that God Almighty will teach us and will give us a new beginning in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. The word of the Lord this morning will liberate us and give us a new hope in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. And I pray that if Christ tarry, if his coming is tarry, and I pray that we do more of this in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. The message of God to us this morning says, the power of forgiveness. The power of forgiveness. Praise the living Jesus. Hallelujah. When we are talking about the power of forgiveness, if you look to the Bible, that is the first thing that Christ taught his disciples. How to forgive others. And the most important things in our life as a Christian is to learn how to forgive others, so that our Father in heaven will forgive us. But today, Christianity today, we doesn't know about forgiveness. There is no forgiveness in our Bible, there is no forgiveness in our dictionary. But if we read through the Bible, we realize that if there is no forgiveness, there is no answer to prayer. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The barrier to unanswered prayer is a strife, bitterness, malice. These are the obstacles to our prayer. These are the reasons that our prayers are not being answered. These are the reasons that we come to the presence of the Lord that we don't be blessed. Because of what? Because of we don't forgive others. Power of forgiveness. If we can achieve that power to forgive others as our Father in heaven forgive us, we will realize that most of our prayer will be answered by fire immediately. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise our mighty Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Let's look at the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 9 to 15. How Jesus Christ taught his disciples how to pray. He said, after this manner, therefore, pray ye, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debt as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thy kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Praise the living Jesus.
Amen.
That is what Christ taught the disciple. That how to forgive others. And as a Christian, if you don't have the spirit to forgive others, we find it difficult for our prayer to be answered. When our heart is full of deceit, and our heart is full of evil, and we want the Holy Spirit to take control of our life, Christ said that I can search the heart, and I give you whatever that is in your heart. But we Christians today, we must learn how to forgive others. See where we read in the Bible today. That the king forgave the servant. And after he forgave the servant went out and saw other servants like himself that owed him just a penny. And he took him and he rough-handed him and he put him into prison. This is how we are doing as a Christian today. We don't know how to forgive and we are expecting God to bless us. We don't know how, we always keep malice. We bitter about things that God has created. When you are bitter about someone, it's an instrument of God. God has created that person. You cannot create anybody. But you just hate that person, which means you hate what God has created. And God said, everything that I've created in the world, they are good. How will you be expecting God to bless you when you hate the instrument of God? We Christians, this is the reason why our prayer has not been answered. We hold grudges. We have bitterness in our heart, and we still come to the presence of the Lord. The Bible says in the presence of the Lord, that's the fullness of joy. How can we be blessed when we are coming to the house of God? Even when we are praying in our home, in our individual prayers, how will we expect God to answer our prayers? How do we pray to God? God that we hold grudge against his instrument. Jesus Christ said, let your Father Lord forgive you as you forgive others. Christian, let us learn how to forgive others. It's a spirit that we need to pray every time. That God, give me the heart to forgive others. Give me the heart to forgive others so that my prayer will be answered. Many of us who have been praying for years, we have never received. Do we search ourselves? Why have I not received that prayer? Why have I not received answer to my prayer? We need to search ourselves and look back to what we have done. At times we try that yes and justify myself. Oh, at times we just put on a smiley face, but your heart is so dirty. But this is God who doesn't look at your heart, but look at your heart. Praise the living Jesus. Praise the living Jesus. Let's look at the Matthew chapter 18, verse 35. It says something. Matthew 18, 35. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It says, so likewise shall my heavenly Father do also unto you, if you from your heart forgive not everyone his brother their trespasses. That is my heavenly Father will do according to you. According to that, if you don't forgive your brother's trespasses, the Bible makes us to understand that if you are bringing offering to the sanctuary of the Lord and you have differences or you have dispute between you and your brother, say, leave that offering and go and make what? Make restitution. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Make restitution so that your brother will be acceptable. See, the offering of a sinner is an abomination. So that you not be wasting your money, wasting time. Brethren, let us try and pray that God should give us the act to forgive others. You see many Christians today. You see many churches today. You see, when you go, that is why God is no more in the church anymore. That is why prayer doesn't answer the church anymore. That's why there's no more miracle anymore in the church. Because the church has been polluted. You see ministers on the altar, they don't talk to each other. You see members, they are singing together, they don't talk to each other. And they are expecting Holy Spirit to take control. How will Holy Spirit dwell in that society? How will Holy Spirit dwell in that church? Praise the living Jesus. Praise the mighty Jesus. The power to forgive. We must make sure that we pray earnestly for the spirit of forgiveness so that our prayer will be answered, so our prayer will be delayed. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's look at the book of Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 9. Jeremiah 17 verse 9. It says, the earth is deceived above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? How can you understand that you know the heart of the man that is sitting by your side? Maybe he's planning to kill you or he's planning to do something. But how will you understand the act? But God who created human being knows the act of human being. He's the one that's going to reward us according to our doing. Praise the living Jesus. We are not praying for any man. We are not praying to any man. But we are praying to God who can seize the heart. Hallelujah. He said the act is deceivable above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? Amen. Look at what he said in Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 14, verse 10. Proverbs 14, 10. Hallelujah. Proverbs 14, 10. It says, the heart knows his own bitterness. Hallelujah. He said, the heart, so woman, we cannot deceive ourselves. If at all, we are just put on smiley face. But God sees your heart. He said, the heart knows his own bitterness. You may be dancing with somebody, you may be smelling with somebody, and your heart is so bitter. Your heart is full of deceit. Your tongue is about evil concerning that person, and you are laughing, you are dancing. Hallelujah. Amen. We are laughing and we are dancing. How will God expect our prayer to be answered? No. He said, the heart knows its own bitterness. You know within you that you are bitter and you are sick with that. Hallelujah. Amen. The heart that is bitter, the heart that heart is sick. Because when your heart is bitter, there is no joy that can come out from that. There is no prosperity that can come out from that. There is no prayer or forgiveness that can come out from that. Because the heart is war is so bitter. Praise the living Jesus. And the stranger does not intermingle in the war in his joy. When your heart is bitter concerning one issue, instead of us to go to God and pray, God, fill my heart. That is why he said that I will create a new heart in you in Ezekiel. I will take the stony heart from you. I will give you the heart of flesh. Hallelujah. Let me say, God, create a new heart in me. Because the heart is polluted. He thought everything about David was so polluted. He said, God, give me a new heart. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Pray that we cannot be calling ourselves a Christian. That there is nothing to show for it. Many of us Christians today, it is only the makeup, what you put on the ID, everything you call us, what makes us, oh, you are beautiful. But the inside is dirty. Hallelujah. Amen. The inside is dirty. When your inside is dirty, how will you pray for others? How will you intercede for others? They are talking about Sunday school this morning, that our personal ministry. Where, how will you minister to others? When our hands is so dirty, our church is evil. How will you minister? How will you do the work God has commissioned unto you? Hallelujah. Praise the living Jesus. Say the heart knows its own bitterness. We cannot deceive ourselves, brethren. We cannot deceive ourselves. Our heart knows that I'm not happy about situation. I'm not happy concerning somebody else. What is the next thing to do is to pray to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Christian, we should not be an entrance or barrier to our prayer life. Many of us, our spiritual life is down because we don't know how to forgive others. How can you live in this world without touching ourselves? How can we live in a society without touching ourselves or without hurting ourselves? But the most important one, to forgive immediately. Hallelujah. How can husband and wife see that at home without having, there is no perfect marriage, the perfect marriage is in heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The perfect marriage world is in heaven. We are living concerning the grace of God. But how will husband and wife live in the same house for years without no argument? Or let they are telling lie. Hallelujah. You may argue on something, but let this war die down immediately. How will a friend be a friend for years without no argument? But let argument die down immediately. Never go back home and say, I will retaliate. I will retaliate. But God says that judgment is mine. He said, vengeance is for, vengeance is mine. So you don't need to stand as, yes, I will revenge. Hallelujah. Amen. God help us, support us in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's go to the book of Matthew chapter 15. Matthew chapter 15. The power of forgiveness. We need the power to forgive others in every area of our life so that our life will be prospered. Hallelujah. Amen. Matthew chapter 15, verse 18 and 97. But those things which proceed out of the mouth come from the heart and define the world, the man. It is not what you are eating, brethren, but what comes out from you. Everything that comes out from you is from your heart. Hallelujah. Everything that comes out from you is from your heart. Your action is from your heart. Your thought is from your heart. For out of the heart proceeded what? Evil thoughts, murders, adultery, fornication, theft, faithlessness, and what? Blasphemy is from what? Our hearts. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. These are the things which define a man, but to eat with unwashed hand define not a man. That is the area we focus, but we don't focus what is coming out from our mouth. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We only look at the area. The area that says, yes, you are eating with this and that, but what is coming out from your mouth is from our heart. Christian, it's a lesson to us today so that we will not be an interest to our prayer. At times we pray, every barrier, every obstacle, and we are the obstacle of our life. Hallelujah. Amen. When we don't have the spirit of forgiveness, when we don't forgive others, that is what we are, the barrier of ourselves. We are the obstacle unto our own prayer. We need to ask God to give us the spirit to forgive others. God should create a new heart in our life. So our life will be prospered. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise our living Jesus.
Amen.
Christian, we have a lot of things to do. Our God is there to work. He see answer prayer. He's God of yesterday, today, and forevermore. He never changed and cannot change. But it's because of our own lifestyle. Because we let it, Jesus Christ said, forgive others, so your Father in heaven will forgive you. You see, we Christians today, we be telling people that until death, that we're not even not in this heaven. It's not in this earth, but on heaven. Hallelujah. Because somebody did something to you, you say, I will never talk to that person until we see in heaven. Who tell you we see in heaven? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said, no. He said, what he did to me, what somebody has done to you that they have never done it before. Hallelujah. What have they done to you that they have never done to somebody before? No. Praise the living Jesus. But by saying that, yes, I will never talk to that person until in heaven. Hallelujah. God will deliver them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's look at the book of Ecclesiastes. The book of Preacher, chapter 9, verse 3. It says something about that. Ecclesiastes, chapter 9, verse 3. It says, this is an evil among all things, that all are done under the sun. And there is one event unto all. Ye also, the heart of the son of man, is full of evil and madness. Hallelujah. He said, the heart of the son of man is full of evil and madness. The heart of man. It's in their heart why they live. It's in their heart why they live. Our heart is full of what? Evil things and madness, and we still live with it. And after that, they go to the dead. Hallelujah. Yeah. And the Bible says that after that, what happened? Judgment. Immediately after this world is judgment. So by you say that it is until heaven, you will receive your war, your judgment. You don't know what will happen anytime from now. When you are seeing any grudge against somebody, he said, don't waste that time. That war, tomorrow will be too late. Your word today, brethren, the word of God today is together with all, make restitution. Go back to wherever you know that you are what? You are having malice, or maybe you are accomplice, or bitterness. Make restitution quick, before it's too late, because you don't know tomorrow. Hallelujah. He said to go on, it'll be too late. And the Bible said that after there is what? Is judgment. It's not an excuse, brethren. It's not an excuse. Make restitution. Do your own part. You see some people today, you greet them, they will not answer you. Continue greeting them. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Just greet them. Either they answer you, you have done your part. Because when judgment comes, you will not. You'll be excluded. Amen. The power of forgiveness, brethren, the Lord will give it to us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's look at the book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 5, verse 8. It says, blessed are the poor in the heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Which means, whosoever their hearts are not pure, they cannot see God. Hallelujah. Whosoever their hearts are not pure, they cannot see God. How will your hearts be pure when we hold grudges against somebody? How will our heart be pure when we have evil thoughts against somebody? And the time is what, so fast. Look at last year, yesterday, January, we are now in December. Hallelujah. Before you know, 2012 is gone. And you are still living with bitterness. We are still living with malice. You never make restitution. Who knows, maybe you will see tomorrow. Who knows when you see next year? Nobody knows. It is better we make restitution now, brethren. The power of forgiveness. Can I see you there?
The power of forgiveness.
Hallelujah. Brethren, when you have bitterness in you, you yourself, you are sick. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because whenever you come across that person, your high blood pressure will high. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Because of what? Because of conflict, because of bitterness, you don't want to see that person. You don't want to talk to that person, and your blood pressure will high. And by the time you have evil talk, the time you are having evil talk against somebody for retaliation, you have many things to do. You are lying on your bed. You are thinking, and yes, how do I retaliate? Before you know, something else coming. Hallelujah. Don't be a portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Christian, we must know the Lord we are serving. That is why many Christians, when we call ourselves Christians, they will call me. Isn't that we perform wonders? But I will tell them, I don't know because you are walking over iniquities. So it doesn't mean that Christians today, we are so many. He said, the way to hell is a broad way. But the way to heaven is what? It's a narrow gate. It's a narrow gate. When you see that people who call themselves a minister in the house of sanctuary of God, they don't talk to each other. The choirs, they don't talk to each other. The ushers, they don't talk to each other. How will Holy Spirit dwell? Hallelujah. In the house of God. And we are inviting the Holy Spirit. We still remember today, if someone is sitting down there because you don't want to talk to you, do not sit down, you go and sit down there. And they say, hallelujah, you are waving hand. We cannot deceive God. We are deceiving ourselves. We need to invite Christ into church today. Christ has departed from church. There is no more church. There is no more Holy Spirit in the house of God anymore. Because of our work, because of our attitude to the work of God. And I pray God will deliver us today in our mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We as a Christian, in our working place, how do you see you as a Christian? You are fighting everybody in your working place. They don't even know you as a Christian. And you are coming to this answer because you are pretending you are holy now. You are deceiving yourself, not God. Brethren, as a Christian, let people know you. Say they are Christ-like. They are Christ-like. Christian world, they are little Christ, which means the attitude of Christ must be in us. Hallelujah. Everything about Christ must be in us. Let people see you that as a world, as a Christ-like. Your attitude, your behavior, anywhere you find yourself, let them recognize you as a Christian. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see many of us today, you cannot talk to them. When you talk to them, you upset them. Christian. Every little thing they are upset. Everything they are upset. How long are you going to upset for? The time is supposed to what? To read your Bible, you need to pray to God and God, give me the spirit of peace. Anything that's happened to us, we need prayer. But then God will give us a power to overcome that spirit in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That's why the book of Timothy chapter 1. 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 5. First Timothy chapter 1 verse 5. It says, now the end of the commandment is charity. Out of a pure heart. Amen. Out of a pure heart. Whatever you are giving to somebody should be your work from your pure heart. Whatever you are giving the work to God must be your pure heart. No matter what you are doing, if it's not from your work, your pure heart, it's just a waste. Hallelujah. See, now the end of the commandment is what is charity, out of a pure heart and of a good conscience. Of a good work, conscience. Hallelujah. God knows, say our body is the temple of God. Where Christ dwells, is it your leg? Is it your head? It's your heart. Hallelujah. He dwells in our heart. Because our heart owns the power of God. That is why the only thing you do wrong, to teach whatever that is come from your heart. If when you look at the biological aspect of it, the heart holds everything in the body. Hallelujah. If the blood doesn't go through the heart anymore, you are dead. If the heart stops today, you are dead. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the heart is the most powerful thing in human being. When the heart stops like this, that is it. Nothing ever. Hallelujah. Amen. So that is why we said that our hearts have to be what? Be pure. Our hearts have to be what? To be pure. See, of what? Of a pure conscience. Hallelujah. The Lord deliver us today in Jesus' name. Pray that the power of forgiveness. The power of forgiveness. This is something that we need to do to cherish most. How to do it? To forgive others. I always make a friend of money as an example. This is just a gift. No matter what you do, no matter anything that you hurt, she is the one that will beg you. Say, oh, don't forget about it yesterday. You're supposed to go and apologize to her. She is the one will tell you, oh, is that because of yesterday, mother? Let us forget it. That is it. It's a gift. Praise the name of Jesus. And you see, maybe say, I will never, he said, I will never greet that. Never, never. In the church of God. In the church of God, you cannot even share the same bread. Hallelujah. That's how devil works. Devil will work that so that you will bring a threat into the life of people so that the spirit of God will never dwell in the church. Amen.
Amen.
In the house of God, where they cannot share, he said, we have one body and one Christ. We cannot share the same bread. We cannot share the same thing. And God said, we want a body of Christ. And the Bible says, if the head is sick, the whole body is what? Sick. If you cannot trust ourselves as a brethren, if you cannot trust ourselves as a Christian, why do we come together as a body of Christ? Why should we come together to worship God? That's why I said, I always say, come. I say, if you are not happy, it is better you don't even come to church that very day. So that you don't be an entrance to other people's prayer. Because when we are praying, and you are not happy, you are full of bitterness, and you are expecting God to fill the whole house, to fill the whole house. No! It is better you don't come so that people will be blessed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
My own sin will not be an obstacle to others in Jesus' name. Praise the name of Jesus. Because when you are coming to the presence of God, which means you stand as an acorn. As an acorn. We are all in this one that we are praying that Holy Spirit take control of every situation. But when we are praying together and we are gathered together and you are not happy, praise the name of Jesus. And you are not happy with it, which means your heart is sick. The Lord will deliver us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Even it's not because I say, brethren, that's why we need to pray before we left home. Pray. If you know that you are not happy, better sit down so your coming will not be what? Vain. It is better you pray that God fill my heart. Let me receive. Let every bitterness depart from me so that you can be received. Otherwise, you will be coming and coming and coming for years and years. The year I don't realize, she realized that no, I've been coming to Shiloh for many years. Enough is enough. She decided. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
She said, no, I'm not eating anymore. There's a reason I'm coming to Shiloh. And that day, the heaven opened. your heaven will be open in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Maybe you'll be coming to church with bitterness. You'll be coming to church with malice. But today the Lord will make your, the Lord will change your situation for good in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whatever that is bringing bitterness to your life, the Lord will open them in my fire and mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I pray the Lord will replace you with a good heart and a pure heart in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's look at the book of Romans chapter 13 verse 8. Romans chapter 13 verse 8. It says, owe no man anything but to love one another. For he that loveth another has fulfilled the law. Hallelujah.
Yes.
He that loveth other as one has fulfilled the law. Remember what Jesus Christ said? He said, I did not come to eradicate the law, but I come to fulfill the law. He said, but of all the old law, the most important in the whole law is what? Is love. Hallelujah.
Yes.
He said, the most important word is love. Our God is what? Is God of love. And what you must understand today, brethren, that whatever you do to any human being, you are doing it to God. Whatever anything you are planning against any human being, you are planning against God. Because God is the creator. He created everything. So whatever you are doing against God. If you are planning to destroy any human being, you are destroying what? The work of God. Any evil thought against any human being is evil thought against the work of God. Do you think that God will be happy? When you are planning evil against his own work, his own hands bear, do you think you'll be happy? As we parents, if anybody is planning evil against our children, are we going to be happy? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are we going to be happy? Or what you have already built for many years, and somebody said, I'm going to destroy that place, are you going to be happy? No. Likewise, we have to look at God. We should not destroy the hand of any handwork of God. And I pray that God will teach us how to live our life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
He said, holy no man anything but to what? To love. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He but to love, hold no man anything, which may never outgrudge against anybody. Put an end to it today. Just go and dig a hole in your house. Dig a hole and bury everything in my world. Bitterness. Go and dig a hole. Everything about grudge, forget it. Let it be the taste of the past. Some people say, it is better I don't eat. I prefer to keep malice, not to eat. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are going on hunger strike. Amen.
Amen.
Whatever will bring love to the body of Christ, we must unite together as a body of Christ. We must all unite together. Look at this apostle. When they started the church in Jerusalem, they said, well, everybody they work, they everything together. They have everything work in common. The water I'm present, this is my bread, they share it. Water, this is my water. This is my house. This is my this. They share all together in work, in love and unity. But the other one that said, no. Ananias and Sapphira, what happened? Because they lie. Nobody asked them. Nobody forced them. But they lied. What happened?
They died.
So, whenever there's a unity that's of God, we must not trespass that. Never be an agon. Never be an obstacle to other people's prayer so that the judgment of God will not be come upon us. And I pray that every bitterness in our life, the Lord will open them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want to jump up this morning. I want to jump up and pray this prayer. Say, Father. Spirit of bitterness in my life today. Let me open the door. Every spirit of bitterness that is bringing my life backward. Open them by fire today, Lord. Every spirit of bitterness, Lord. Open them, open them, open them, open them, open them. In the name of Jesus. Every spirit of bitterness, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. It is better. You see what the Bible says? It didn't say you should not be war. It said, don't be war upset. You can be upset. It's yes, you can be upset, but don't let sun, even that very day, don't let sun set. Immediately forget it and let it pass. But because of our pride and because of the arrogance in our life, we cannot come say sorry. Sorry is very far away from Christian today. To say sorry. I'm just only sorry. S-O-R-R-Y can turn people's life around for good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sorry does not mean for your age. So it does not move anything. It doesn't matter about the things of the Lord. Say sorry. It doesn't work. Take anything from you. It is better you say sorry for life to move forward. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many of us we are in problem for many years because of what we can't say sorry. If you cannot say sorry to God, how will you say sorry to man? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pray today. Say, Father.
Father.
Every bitterness in my life.
Every bitterness in my life.
That are bringing my life backward.
That are bringing my life backward.
Father, open them today in the name of Jesus. Father, open them today, Lord. Open them today, Lord. Open them today, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Daddy, open them, Lord. Daddy, open them, Lord. Every bitterness, Lord. Open them, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Because of spirit that we cannot forgive, he has destroyed many homes. He destroyed many families. He destroyed many lives. Because we don't have the spirit of forgiveness. He destroyed many things. Either the husband to say sorry, all you have to say sorry. They keep on hanging on, hanging on, hanging on, and then they continue to walk, interpret, interpret, interpret. Before you know, separation comes. And when separation comes, it affects the children. Just sit down and talk it over. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just sit down and walk, talk it over. That's it. And let's move on. But they keep on going, 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 until the devil interprets and what? Scatter the whole house. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord will deliver us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As a Christian, for us, so that we know our intimacy with heaven will not be destroyed. Our intimacy with God will not be destroyed. We should have this prayer of forgiveness. So that your voice will be recognized in heaven. When your life is full of bitterness, your voice can never be recognized in heaven. Nobody knows you in heaven. Because the Spirit of God, which is the candlestick in your life, has disappeared. The Spirit of God, that is the candle to search everything area of your life, where you wake, to what, to amend it, the Spirit of God has disappeared, has disappeared, departed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I pray today the Lord give us the power to make restitution in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Brethren, restitution is very, very important. You can be restitution to God, what of woman be? He said, whatever you do to any brethren, you have done it to me. You said, oh, yes, I pray to God. God will answer my prayer. And she keep on hanging. Hallelujah. The next thing you're supposed to make a restitution so that your prayer will be answered. You said, no, I'm a pardon. And you say, God, God will never answer until you will make restitution. Until you forgive. Until you forget. And God said, we are human beings. How can we forgive? How can we forget? Hallelujah. You need the Spirit of God in your life. When the Spirit of God dwells in you, He will pull you down and remove your life. He will pull you down completely. Every spirit of pride in you will be removed. Every spirit of arrogance will be removed. It is not you, Spirit of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are all human beings. We are so difficult. But when the Spirit of God pulls you down, people will look at you and say, this is my sister before, I know her before, but now she's another person entirely. It's not her, it's the Spirit of God dwelling in her life. And I pray to the brethren, as you take this step of faith to make restitution, and the Spirit of God will descend upon you in Jesus.
Amen.
Let us pray the last prayer. Say, Father.
Father.
Right from this moment.
Right from this moment.
Create a new heart in me, Lord.
Create a new heart in me, the name of
Jesus. Create a new heart in me, Lord. My heart has been polluted, Lord. Create a new heart in me, Lord. You said in the book of Ezekiel that I will create a new heart and I will remove the stony heart from them. I will give them the heart of flesh. Then He gave me, Lord, a new heart. Create me a new heart, Lord. So I will not miss heaven. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Pray this prayer, brethren. That every spirit of pride in me.
Every spirit of pride in me.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brethren, we find it in many areas in the Bible. Pride. And this when pride is in our life, the spirit of forgiveness can never enter. Because the pride in our life has said, I cannot surrender. I cannot surrender. I cannot surrender. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. You see many nations today, how they were destroyed because they cannot surrender. God has been warning us, surrender, but we don't want to surrender. Whosoever that cannot surrender to God will be destroyed. Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pray then, pray. We all have element of pride in our life. We cannot deceive ourselves. We are all human beings. There are always element of pride in us, but they are so much in their life that He has controlled their life entirely. But we need to ask God this morning. Every element of pride in me.
Every element of pride in me.
Let it consume
my fire.
Every element of pride in me,
Lord.
Let it consume my fire. Let it consume my fire. Let it consume my fire. Every element of pride. Every element of pride in me. Let it consume, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, if husband and wife cannot submit to each other, that marriage can never stand, brethren. Take it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If the husband is claiming right, the marriage cannot stand. If the wife is claiming right, the marriage cannot stand. Both of them have to know how to manage them, and God should be the foundation of the house. When we know, we back home, we know our own, our heritage, our culture. Hallelujah. We know our culture. Our culture says, yes, we are the head. Yes, the man is the head. But if you want to enjoy your life to the fullness of your, you need to do what? You need to understand it's different. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
If you need to understand what is different, you need to manage yourself. You need God to manage your life. You need Christ in your background. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So we should not say everything we must be right. No. It's not like I'm right. No, one must be wrong, one must be right for our marriage world to stand. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Look at Christ, Jesus Christ. When they say Jesus Christ, you must pay tithe. You must pay. Does he argue? No, he doesn't argue. He knows it's right. He has the authority. All of you are dead. No. He said, let us walk, give this out what?
Caesar.
He said, Peter, go to the fish and give them what? What is right? Duty Christ doesn't have the power. No. He has the power. But he gives them, yes, that's what they need. Everybody are paying time. Let me do what? Let me do it. I paid. So, brethren, let us have the power of forgiveness. Let us be doing in our life. How to forgive others. He said, when we cannot forgive from whom, we cannot forgive outside. And I pray today the message of today will have impact in your life in Jesus.
Amen.
I said today, the turning around for good will be your life in Jesus.
Amen.
The word of God is to teach us and to direct us. Because prayers are coming very soon, and we are coming to the presence of God to receive. Let bitterness be the taste of the power right from today. And I pray today will be a new beginning of your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Then we thank you, Lord. We appreciate you to the Lord.
Thank you,
because of your word that you have sent to us. We cannot do this by our power, but we need your strength, Daddy. We need your power, Lord. We need your spirit, Lord, to direct us and to fill us from above. So we have the spirit to forgive others. Let your power born upon us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let our inner man receive the fire of Holy Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the power to forgive others. As you have said, that when we forgive others, we forgive us. So our life will prosper. That is, I pray to the Lord. Let us be full upon the people in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Tell us for answering our prayer.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.